Hello everyone, in today's tutorial we are going to learn the design of spur gear and we will cover three main topics. First, easiest way to design the spur gear in SolidWorks. Second, we will discuss the material used for the spur gear, and third, how to reduce the weight of the gear. So let's get started. When we open SolidWorks, select file, select new part and select OK. Now the first method is we draw the addendum circle, dedendum circle, pitch circle and make gear profile and use circular pattern to make gears. But this is time consuming. Second method is we go to the tools and select equations to create gears. But this is also time consuming. Third method is we use design library and toolbox. If you don't have toolbox option here, go to the settings, use add-ins, select this box and click OK. Now again go to the design library, select toolbox, go to the ISO, select power transmission, go to the gears, right click on the spur gear and use create part. Now in the configure component we have to change these values. So module is, we select module 5. Module is basically pitch circle diameter divided by number of teeth. Number of teeth we select 20. Pressure angle is 20, face width we select 30. Type A hub. Type A hub means this normal hub. Type B hub means it provides hub at one side like this. And type C means it provides hub at both sides. So we select type A. Nominal shaft diameter we select 20. Keyway square. Teeth show 20. Select OK. So this is our gear. We can change the background from here. Now the important aspect is material selection. Go to the appearance, select metals, select steel, select brush steel, drag and drop the brush steel and select body. Gears can be made of all sort of material including brass, bronze, cast iron, ductile iron, plastics. Now there is reason to select steel because steel is most common material overall and offer high resistance to wear. Now we see how to reduce the weight of the gear. Before that we should know how to calculate the weight of this gear. So go to the tools, go to the evaluate, select mass properties and here mass is 217 grams. Use density and volume and cancel it. Right click on the surface and select sketch normal to remove this grid. Select circle, draw one circle here, give dimension. Select center line, draw one center line here, and give dimension 25. Exit sketch. Go to the feature, use extrude cut and here select through all and click OK. Now again go to the circular pattern, select this circle and in direction select here and use this face. And here put how many holes we need. We need 5 holes and click OK. Again select this surface and sketch normal to, select circle, draw one circle here and one here, select dimension, give dimension 30, select this circle, give dimension 78, okay, and exit sketch. Again go to the features, use extrude cut, now software ask the length, how deep we need to cut the hole, we need 8 mm, select OK. You cannot select mirror option here directly, let me show you why. If you went to mirror, this plane should be at the center of this gear, so we have to make the plane first. Go to the reference geometry, select plane, then select plane 3 and here give length 15 mm and select OK. Now select extrude cut 2, select mirror, select plane 4 and see. Again we have to calculate the weight, so again go to the tools, evaluate mass properties and see weight is reduced. So this is how we reduce the weight of the gear. That's our spur gear, try to make it, and if you have any query feel free to ask in the comment section. If you find this video informative, like this video and subscribe to the channel for upcoming educational videos. Thanks for watching the video.